Next type of keys are your navigation keys. They are your arrow keys, home and page up and page down. You use the arrow keys to move the cursor up, down, right and left. The home key moves the cursor to the left end of a line of text. End key moves the cursor to the end of a line. Page up key is used to move one page up, and page down key is used to move one page down while you view any kind of document. Next we have your numeric keyboard. Not all keyboards have numeric keyboard. If available, this is a separate set of keys with numbers from 0 to 9 and the decimal point, special characters and navigation symbols. All of this is there in a special set of keys that is termed as your numeric keyboard. The numlock key on this keypad allows you to switch between the numeric and the navigation keys. If numlock key is switched on, then you can type through the numeric keyboard, and if it is switched off, then you can use the rest of the keyboard. Okay, so this is all about your keyboard usage, how to operate your keyboard. Next, let's talk about how to use a mouse. So again, it's an input device, as you all know. It's a small device that you can use to move, select and open items on your computer screen. The mouse is usually kept on the desk next to the keyboard. Most mouse devices have at least two buttons, left and right. Most of the actions are performed by clicking the left button, and right button is used for specific functions. Some advanced types of mouse devices provide additional buttons to speed up common tasks such as your scrolling, text to move up and down. As you move the mouse on your desk, a pointer moves correspondingly on your screen. You're moving the mouse on the desk and you can see the movement of the pointer on the screen. As you can see the pointer over here. If I'm moving my mouse, the pointer is also moving. This movement I'm talking about, okay? So the mouse allows you to select an item on the screen. As you move the pointer over different areas of the screen, the items or the pointer change. Their shape changes. These changes indicate that you can click an item to open it or see more of its options. You can open an item by moving the pointer to it and clicking the left button twice. In a document, you can use the mouse to select a position to start typing. You need to position the pointer in the document, click where you want to insert text, and then use your keyboard to begin typing. Next, to move an item, you need to click it and then, holding the mouse button down, move the item to a different location. After you move the item to the new location, you release the mouse button. The right button on the mouse is used to display a menu. The options on this menu include the most common tasks such as copying text from one location and pasting it to another location. These are called context sensitive menus. These menus help you complete tasks quickly. Most mouse devices also have a wheel that help you to scroll through documents or pages. To scroll, place your finger on the wheel and roll it back and forth. This moves the document up and down. There are different types of mouse devices available in the market. A regular mouse has a rubber or a metal ball on the underside. The mechanical movement of the mouse device moves the ball. This movement further moves the pointer on the screen. An optical mouse can be used in the same way as a regular mouse. However, it does not have a ball, it uses a laser to detect movement. So this is all about your mouse, how to use your computer, keyboard and mouse. We are done with the two topics today and one worksheet of the previous topics. In next class, you will be getting another worksheet of these topics that we have done today, and then we will proceed with the next topics. Thank you so much all.